Have you heard about El Peso Hero?
No.
He's the Mexican-American superhero that recently has saved Ukrainian civilians.
What?
Yeah, man.
No
way. Look at El Peso Hero in Ucrania.
What the heck?
Did you know about Mexican superhero?
No.
No, hombre.
El Superman.
No, sacaron el de la lotería.
El Atlas. For the better part of the decade, the Mexican-American superhero created by Hector Rodriguez has helped immigrants along the U.S. border fight Mexican cartels, corrupt officials, and human trafficking.
What?
Dude, this dude is doing a better job than the Mexican army.
Dude, yeah.
Right?
That's crazy.
So Mexico's refusal to criticize Russia or support Ukraine. Like, you know, Mexico has been like in a...
Like he's challenged them, right?
No, like he's just kind of been in the middle. Like
no, but
the Mexican president,
the UK president has challenged Mexico. Why don't you guys go back and take your? You didn't hear about that?
No, I didn't hear about that.
Yeah, he challenged Mexico, and he was like, "I challenge Mexico to go and get their land back." And I don't know why you guys won't do it. You know, because he's taking his back. So he's challenging Mexico to take Texas and California back.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
There is no way that's happening.
Exactly. I don't know about that. I don't know, but that would be, that wouldn't be pretty.
Look, it says, it's El Peso Hero saying, well, if the president of Mexico is not able to be there, El Peso Hero will be, Rodriguez told NPR in the special 18-page free online issue. Let's go check it out. Man, I didn't know there was a fucking Peso Hero.
Me neither.
The fuck? Look, El Peso Hero travels to Ukraine in search of a missing Mexican Red Cross member and plunges himself into protecting refugees in the midst of the invasion. The digital issue is free, but please take a moment to donate to UNICEF. So this is a government-sponsored fucking comic book.
Like that? Oh, let's see what they're trying to do.
No. Speaking of Doja Cat, speaking of female rappers, Doja Cat confirms she will disappear after she fulfills the current music obligations.
What?
I know, right?
What do you mean? Yeah, she's so freaking unique. Like, dude, there is nobody like her.
How come you didn't mention her in your top three?
Because you know what? You said rapper, and she didn't come to my mind when you said rapper.
What?
She's more of a singer to me.
What? No, Doja Cat is a fucking rapper.
She's like a singer/rapper.
Mm-hmm. She's a rapper/singer.
Well, I feel like she doesn't have a category. Because she can do anything.
Yeah,
anything. Yeah. There's nobody like her.
You can't hold a woman in a box. No, we're not talking about that.
No. But you can't, like, put someone next to her. You know what I mean? Like, who are you going to compare her to?
SZA, maybe?
SZA doesn't sound nothing like her.
I know. Nobody sounds like Doja Cat. But nobody sounds like SZA either. Who else sounds like...
But I mean, like, Doja has, like... to me, she's so unique. Like, I don't know anybody, like, with her style.
What about, Dani Leigh?
Dani Leigh is I think it's just more R&B. Like, to me, she's, like, more R&B, more laid back.
Yeah, yeah.
And Doja can play up, play down, do whatever she wants. Like, she's amazing.
You know, she comes from a family of artists. Her parents were
Doja?
Artists. Yeah.
No.
Her parents are, like, fine artists or something. Like... they're well known in the art community, and she grew up around that, and that's why she's so fucking like top notch.
I didn't know that.
I put Doja Cat in my top three as far as female rappers.
Yeah, so now I'm regretting it. Now I regret it, but I had to put Snow in there. Snow in there.
No, Snow the Product for sure.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, and you got to give Nicki credit too.
Nicki. I think that's my top three: Nicki, Doja, and Snow.
There you go. I had to put someone from Dallas though. She's coming up. Because there's not really any female like from Dallas.
Erykah Badu.
Is she a rapper?
No. She does more like sing.
Yeah, she's a singer. Like,
okay,
rapper-ish.
But she also did rap too.
Like, what song?
I mean.
The most famous song of her?
That's a little bit though. It's more like singing rap. Like,
hey, I'm tired of you. I'm tired of you girls not giving female rappers their props. You guys are always trying to tell them that
she's not labeled as a rapper though. Like, if you name, like, give me a rapper, they're not gonna say Erykah Badu.
No.
You know what I mean?
Well, how about Megan Thee Stallion? Do you like her?
I like Megan Thee Stallion.
Megan Thee Stallion is fire.
All her songs are. amazing.
Yeah. Have you seen her Tiny Desk concert that she put on Tiny Desk?
On NPR?
You should go back and watch that. No, that one's pretty good.
I saw the video, though, of that music video, the pie something. That was kind of weird.
Is it new?
I think, it just came out maybe a month or two. It's with someone else, but...
I really like her Young Thug one. What's it called? Don't Stop. Don't Stop.
That one, I love that one. Yeah, that one's good, too.
I could definitely work out to that one. I could work out to...
You do your squats with...
Yeah, whenever I do leg day, I put Megan Thee Stallion on.
I gotta get my Megan knees.
Oh!
I put on Thug Shit.
Oh, Lord.
That's great.
Whatever hypes you up. We don't judge you.
Let's see. Okay, so as far as workout music, who do you bang?
So there's this female that I love. She's not very well known yet. To me, she is, but she is from New York. Shout out to Abby Jasmine. If you haven't heard of Abby Jasmine, have you heard of Abby Jasmine? Man, she's next. Like, She got some bars. Yeah.
Really?
She got bars. Okay. Yeah. Okay, cool. She's amazing. I love her.
Look her up. Add her to our playlist.
Yeah. So if you do, look up her Trap Mom album. I think it's actually an EP. And there's two songs to No Hook and Cavassier. Okay. Those two on my playlist.
Gotcha.
Repeat. The No Hook one, though. No. She went off on that one. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right, let's see what else we got. Okay, so we'll just take a look at this. So this guy walks into a police station.
What?
Shoots inside of a police station.
Just a random guy.
Yeah. Everybody hit the floor. Nobody move. Everybody hit the floor. So then they pursue to follow this motherfucker. Obviously, it's guns drawn. He's already busting back. They located the suspect. The suspect raised the weapons towards the suspect.
Dang. What the heck?
Damn, they did a clip on him.
Yeah, they did.
He's
still alive.
He was transported to a nearby hospital for treatment.
That's like law-abiding citizen movie right there.
The suspect was charged with first-degree attempted intentional homicide and numerous other felonies. No department personnel or civilians were injured during this incident.
Well, thank God, but... Still, nobody was hurt because they were just shooting the place.
What the fuck was he thinking going inside of a police
station?
That's
what I'm saying. Like, what the heck was... I want to know what he was thinking.
Let's watch that again. Hold on.
He was trying to get a ticket off of his record or something.
He said, I'm going to get some motherfucking service around here. It's the fucking last thing I fucking do.
Dang.
Y'all didn't get my burger right.
Yeah.
Y'all didn't get my burger
in the wrong place.
He said, I want some Black Lives Matter around this motherfucker.
Was that him right there in the back?
Yeah.
He was just like, fuck the police. He was jamming to that song before he got there.
he listened to too much NWA on the way. He was like, that's, you know what, I'm going to pull over this motherfucker.
Yeah, fuck these niggas.
We got squashed this right now. After firing the final shot, the suspect fled. So I don't know if he was aiming at the police officers or he was just shooting the ceiling or whatnot. But either way, dumb ass move, dumb ass
Why
motherfucker.
Would you do that?
He got shot. He's lucky he didn't get killed at the fucking end.
I thought he died.
Dude, I'm on the fucking cop side on this one. You know what I mean? I'm usually on the other side, but no.
Criminal side?
Yeah.
Well, he must have to be on drugs or something. Or he knew something. And there I go with my conspiracy stuff. Something happened there.
It's because, they probably didn't do a good job of finding, who murdered his brother.
Something like that, right?
I don't know. All right, let's see.
Three Brothers type of movie.
That's a good movie.
Four Brothers, right?
Is it Four Brothers or Three Brothers? Oh, Four Brothers, my bad.
That was with Sofia Vergara.
Yeah, Sofia Vergara with Tyrese.
Tyrese
and Mark Wahlberg and... Andre 3000? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And what was the fourth one?
Huh?
What was the fourth one?
I don't know. The other guy, the little one. The little one. The little kid. I don't know his name. I forgot his name.
I don't remember him. Okay, so check this out. So, girl gets jumped at a trampoline.
What? Dang, these are teenagers. No, see, no. You don't know. You let them squash one.
Man, they should have done it on the trampolines.
Wrestling?
They should have spurred.
Yeah. You know how, like, they do from wrestling?
I would have done a backflip on that bitch.
Damn, she just slapped her.
I would have ran, like, jumped onto the trampoline and bounced back.
Hell yeah.
Hell that's yeah. Unfair, though. That's three against one. Come on now.
The person in the back is like, okay, I'm gonna.
Yeah, well, right, he was jumping here before that, right?
Yeah.
He was like having fun, and then imagine if you're there with your kids.
There they are. Look on the right over here. They're just like, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, no.
Oh, yeah, there is that lady with their kids. Yeah.
No, see.
There's small kids in here.
Did someone drop them off just to do that?
I don't know.
That's crazy.
But it's on
site. You've seen moms that do that, right? They just drop their kid off to fight someone else.
Are you serious?
Really? Yeah, you haven't seen, like, those videos where, like, a mom or the dad, usually it's a mom, drops off the kid so she can just get in a fight with the other female.
It's usually at Walmart, yeah.
That's some ratchet stuff.
Yeah, that's why I don't go to Walmart, though.
Yeah, avoid you Walmart at all costs.
Yes.
You know, they got Sam's, they got Target.
They have Target.
You know, Target is a little bit more expensive, but you know what?
See,
just stick to the Michoacana, please.
I like the carne there. Everybody goes. The gringos go over there and get... There was a female from Alaska that said that one time I went to the Michoacana, and she was like talking to me, and she's like, I'm actually getting the fish. Nobody that, you know, this is the best carne, like the best fish. I'm actually going straight home to Alaska. I'm like, you're from Alaska? Yeah, I'm like, that's crazy. Okay. Yeah. Michoacana got fans everywhere. Yeah, right?
What the fuck? From Alaska?
I know. Yeah, that's like the craziest. And yeah.
I never thought about getting fish from Michoacana ever.
Yeah, but I mean, she got everything. She got carne asada, like for the tacos. Mm-hmm.
Oh,
and she got fish too to take.
No, that's why that's why she's going there for the carne asada. Yeah. Because she knows there ain't no Michoacanos.
She got this up in Alaska.
Man. Yeah, they got aliens over there.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
How dare you!